Wentworth Street was built in 1640. The history of Universal House is unclear. Wildermuth's lodging house once stood here. It was known as a flop house or hostel, which housed criminals and prostitutes. Right next door to Universal House is Toynbee Hall. It was created in 1884 by Samuel Barnett and his wife Henrietta. Toynbee Hall is a charity that offers help to the poor, including youth and the elderly. They offer advice on financial inclusion and debt. The streets of this area are well known because of its famous killer, Jack the Ripper.
My name is Joanne Wong. I'm a student at Central Film School London. I'm doing an interview documentary for Universal House. I'm here in the office with a gentleman. Can you please state your name?
My name is Jaimin Timur, and I'm working here as a manager, and I'm working since 2009.
All right, that's really good. I have done research regarding Universal House. However, I'm still unclear of its history. What year was Universal House built?
It was built in the 18th century, and it's before World War start. But then after, so many work was done on here, and there's a couple of story built up here. And in a World War, he's got the damage here under the other side part of the building, and it was rebuilt. Still the wall, one of the wall is still there. But that's amazing. They just build it up, and now you can see on which condition this building is here.
Okay. Wildersmooth Lodging House once stood where Universal House is today. It was known as a flop house or a hostel. Do you know anything of the lodging house that stood here before?
It's not a really big lodging house or something. It used to be as a factory, and a small part was the lodging house. But now, once Mr. Mehta bought this building in the 1986, after he converted this building into the offices, and everything was moved, all the factories, business are now closed, and the whole building is turned into the offices.
What's fun working here, and what's not fun to work here?
The funny part is, I got so much experience here, and I'm building myself from the scratch, because I had never worked in somewhere else in the UK. And since I working here, I got so many different kind of experience. I got so many opportunity to learn something new. Mm-hmm. And unfunny part is I'm working alone here, so I don't have another employee who can always help me out and all that stuff. So yeah. That's, you can say, is a little bit boring part of this job. But apart from that, it's really good work.
Go up to the roof to get some fresh air. Maybe we could continue talking during for interview.
Definitely we can go upstairs on the roof and enjoy the fresh air.
What year did you purchase Universal House?
Yeah, Mr. Mehta purchased this building in 1986, and he was one of the tenants here, and one day he just bought the building.
Who were the first owners of Universal House, and was it always an office?
The first owner was Jewish, at least that's I know, but I don't know exactly his name. And that used to be a factory on that time, but after the 1986, I know exactly how it's worked out. Mm-hmm. And there's the reason about this building and convert into the offices.
What do you know about clothing manufacturing in the area?
Clothing manufacturing at that time is clothing business is one of the biggest business in England.
Mm-hmm.
And this part of the area was biggest clothing market in the whole London. So almost everyone is in the clothing business. The people are getting that work, and everything was jumping and booming here.
Mm-hmm.
But as you know, every business have up and down. And clothing businesses also have this kind of down turn up.
Yeah.
And And after, yeah, it's around 18 and 90s, the business was come down. And mm-hmm. now you can see we had like a different kind of businesses in Universal House.
Okay.
That is a Liverpool Street. On this side, we can get like a European biggest building is a Sard. And here is so many development is going on. We can see on that side is a walkie. And just behind this building, we have a Gherkin building, which is like a landmark of the London. And nowadays, you can see this part of the city part is like developing quite fast. We have one of the new building, Cheese Grater, which is quite amazing.
What do you know about the rich history of the surrounding areas of Wentworth Street and Brick Lane?
The Brick Lane is like a very historical place. There's like a Bengali community from the Bangladesh turn up here, and they start their like a community area, their territory in this area. But also the Brick Lane is very well known for the Indian curry. We had like so many restaurants on the Brick Lane. And nowadays it's like a very amazing place for like a Friday night and Saturday night. It's like, and for a youngsters, it's like a best place to having a curry and have some kind of Indian taste.
Famous killer Jack the Ripper. What have you heard about the history of this killer?
The Jack the Ripper. The Jack the Ripper is living in just around the corner on the Gunthorpe Street. Yeah, still there is like a pub there, and on the below the pub he was used to be live there. And nowadays like it's like one of the tourist place. It's like a tourist attraction, and whenever the like people the tourists turn up here, they must have the tour of the Jack the Ripper, and we can have a guide, and they will like have like a few minutes tour, and they can give like a more information about the Jack the Ripper.
Universal House, what do you see as in the future?
At this moment, we are working on like a couple of projects. Mr. Mahindra is like a solo owner, and we are thinking to develop the Universal House as much as possible. Now we can see this area is growing up, so with that we have to like keep running ourselves, and we are trying to developing like thinking to make two more stories on top of this, and try to develop it. And also we are making some kind of internal changes into the communal area, even try to provide more facility to our tenants, and also thinking to put the air conditioning in next 1 year, so like we don't have any more problem, and my tenants can have as much as comfortability in the Universal House.
Thank you very much for the interview.